this talent and focus, ladies and gentlemen. Only one man can do it, and it's Brent Rose. Give it up for Brent Rose. Sextet.
Thank you. Thank you guys so much. That was called City Park Blues. so much. It was a song called The Dilemma. I have a good friend of mine here in New Orleans that is a great songwriter. We had this long debate about writing songs and the best way to write songs. And so a lot of times when I write songs, I have a groove in mind or a specific rhythm in mind. Sometimes I have the melody in mind or the chord progression, but my friend basically said that you should always start with the chord progression, otherwise you tend to take stuff that's already been used. And so I was determined at that point to write something the opposite, just to be difficult. And I ended up with incredible writer's block because of forcing the issue or whatever. So I ended up calling this last song The Dilemma because it was part of this process I went through, and I was like, oh, what do I do, what do I do? And so it kind of had these two parts to it. It started out fast and slow and stuff with all these different things, but eventually it came out. This next song, by the way, is called Slow Your Roll. I don't know if my kids are here yet, but it's probably written for them. They gotta calm down. They're here somewhere.
I don't hear them.
No.
You got it, Tom.
Just for the dance.
It's like orange beer.
Thank you.
There you are. Where you at, Sam? They finally showed up. The Slow Your Rollers are in the house, y'all, so guard your drinks.
Give it a hand one more time for Mr. Oscar Rossignoli on the piano. Woo! And see y'all on the guitar, Mr. Scott Myers. Scott had his first baby about 3 months ago almost.
Not me.
Well, not you. You look fabulous, dog. His wife had their first child about 3 months ago. We're super excited about us, yeah.
We are. Rafael?
Rafael.
Apollo, where is Apollo? Where's Apollo at, man? Where is Apollo?
He's not here.
Apollo, yeah, Apollo.
On the bass, Mr. Tommy Sciple. On the drums, Mr. Peter Varnado. On the trumpet, Eric and I have known each other for how long? A while. We've been really good, almost probably best friends. Our bellies were a lot less. We've been playing music together and a lot of really cool New Orleans bands. Thank you for that. For at least 2 decades. And it's a real treat always to have him on the stage. Y'all make some noise for Mr. Eric and Sarah.
Thank you.
for you, Sam. What about Noah? Alex?
Thank you. Thank you guys for coming out.